Welcome to our next installment of our series, Body Parts. In this episode, we're going to be dealing with the ear. Honestly, this is one of the easier parts of the body to create. But, like many of the other items, they all could be different, they all have different shapes. You have a lot of flexibility with how the ear is shaped. But there are certainly some rules that you need to follow. Certain parts of the ear are consistent. The outer rim, called the helix, for one. But let's take a look at how this is created. We open a session of our Aspire. We have our picture. This is the original head that we're trying to mimic or replicate. I found online a picture of an ear that I thought was appropriate. Again, you have a lot of flexibility to be able to create what you'd like. And by now you probably should know the process. Simply drawing vectors and creating shapes. And of course, using the sculpting tool to blend, to smooth, to smudge, and add and delete material. The fundamental basics, the foundation for doing good 3D modeling, starts with vectors. I create individual vectors for the individual parts of the ear. I take my time to make sure they're pretty accurate. And just a note, I try to make sure that I have the least amount of nodes possible. Once the vectors are completed, I start creating shapes, simple dishes or domes, and sometimes a pyramid shape. I do know that I will be smoothing all of these out. Personally, I'd like to make individual components so that I can adjust them as needed. Throughout this video, I'm going to speed it up quite a bit, simply because we know the process. Creating vectors, creating shapes, and smoothing as needed. The more you work with this, the better you get. It's not about speed, but more about efficiency and planning ahead. Thinking forward, what it's going to look like when it's completed. After creating my components, I'll make a copy of the visible model and use that in my sculpting tool to start to smooth and smudge. I go through the process of trying to manipulate the components to match the image, but it's not working as best as possible. So I find it probably would be better if I did each component separately. So let's just delete this and go back to our component tree and individually pick the components and manipulate them as needed. Could leave the ear as it is, and it would be okay for the purpose that we need, simply because in the end result, we really can't see much of the detail of the inner ear. Our head is facing forward, so you only see a side view of the ear. This is an area that you'll need to decide what to do. Do we spend a lot of time on this ear trying to make it perfect from a side view? Or do we just do a representation of an ear? Because again, you don't have a very close look at the ear when it's finished. But I'm going to work through just some of the ideas here. I'm going to take each component, take it into the sculpting tool, and manipulate it as need be. This is just one approach, a different option. My individual parts get adjusted. This will be a rather quick video, as there's really not that much to talk about. It's simply creating vectors and creating component shapes and sculpting. Smooth, smudge, add, subtract if needed. I know in the end, the ear is not going to be totally visible because we're looking at it from a front view. And you don't see much of the details of the inner ear. Once finished, I'll export it as a 3D model and then re-import it so that we can position it as need be. based upon our picture of the head. This portion of the project takes a little guesswork. You have to sort of adjust it as need be, on an angle. Hopefully I can get this on the first try. Reduce the size and rotate it if need be, and position it. Once I'm happy with it, I'll make a copy of it and mirror it to the right-hand side. So now I have a left and right ear. That's as far as we need to go with the ear itself, because as you can see, we don't see a whole lot of it. It's not that critical. I hope it makes some sense. Ears are pretty easy to make. I hope you'll give it a try. For our next lesson, we're going to take our component parts that we've created, the lips, the nose, the eyes, and the ears, and we're going to put them together to create our head. We're almost finished. Hang in there. You'll see how this head comes together nicely. If you'd like to learn more about the software, subscribe to our channel. But don't forget to click on the bell to be notified of our next video. And as always, if you have any questions, send me an email. mm@mezalick.com. I'll try to help out. If you'd like to buy me a cup of coffee, I'd appreciate it. Thanks for your support. See you next time. Enjoy.